In the studio with me from the YMCA of Eastern Ontario, I'm talking with Director of Regional Operations and Programs. I happen to be talking to Emily Wimpenny. And welcome to the program.
Thanks for having me.
I understand that the March to June program guide is now out.
It is out. Yes. Registration actually opened yesterday.
Good.
So we were very busy that first hour of registration and throughout the day. There are some spaces left in some of our programs, but all that information, you can grab the program guide in person at the Y or on our website.
So people, should they, can they tell whether or not if they go to their website, if there happens to be a certain program that they wanted to take, I don't know, Aquafit, just for instance, and it happens to be full, will it say full?
Yes, yeah. So on our website is a link to our registration portal.
Yes.
And if they go into that, they're able to see how much space is left in programs.
Okay.
Fortunately, Aquafit's drop-in, so you can show up. There's always room, or we'll make room.
Yes.
But for most of our registered programs, it'll tell you whether there's room or if it's full, and at what point it'll tell you you can add yourself to a wait list.
So don't be, you know, thinking about this too long. Go in and check and sign up. Don't wait, or you're going to be disappointed.
Yes, spaces go quickly. Most of our swim lessons have already gone in the first day.
Wow. So let's talk about some of the programs that would be appearing in the guide. Now, if I remember correctly, I went online and I was looking at what is offered here in Brockville. There's anything and everything. I mean, you go from babies and mum swimming all the way up to whatever age. You've got all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, we like to think we have something for everybody, or at every age and stage is kind of how we put it. And so we've got things starting for infants, like swim lessons. So we offer parent and taught swim lessons, which is a great skill for the children, but also a great opportunity for the parents to get out and socialize with other young parents or parents in the community. We have lessons for programs for preschool children, for school age. We offer a lot of teen programming, and then right through into that adult and senior category. So we offer a wide range of fitness classes, whether it's for that young person or an older person who's fit and looking to enhance their fitness, or for someone who's new to fitness and just looking to get it started. Their staff are great at helping you pick what program is good for you.
Well, I like that idea. And I like the idea that you do have a staff that can kind of, you know, suggest to people, maybe you'd like to try this, as opposed to just going in and saying, yeah, I want that, and then not be happy in that particular program for whatever reason.
Yeah.
So it's nice to have somebody to talk to.
It is, yeah. And one of the benefits of membership is you actually get free wellness orientations.
Oh.
So one of our trainers will meet with you. So it's not personal training where they're following you around.
No.
But what they do is they give you a one-on-one orientation to our center. And so if you share with them what your goals are, they'll show you some machines that'll help you reach that and make sure they match your fitness level.
Wow, I didn't know that. That is really, that's good service.
That's like
very good service. Yes, definitely. So the guide itself, people can pick this up, they can go through it, decide what they want to do, and not wait. Really, go online and sign up if you're going to. Let's talk about outreach, if you don't mind, because it's not just Brockville and Kingston wise, right?
That's correct.
You actually go out into the community with some other programs.
We do, yeah. So we have a great Mobile Y program. So that's a program for seniors.
Mm-hmm.
And we go to rural communities. So some of those underserved populations that maybe don't have the access to some of the services we do in our urban centers. And we offer fitness classes once a week in most of those communities. So we're pretty proud of that. It's a great program. It's funded through the ministry, which is super wonderful. It removes another barrier. So we're taking away that transportation barrier and then hopefully some of that financial burden.
Yeah.
So that's one of our outreach programs. In the summers, we're in Gananoque. We run a teen drop-in program at the berm. So that'll be back this summer.
Nice.
And then we also partner with some of the municipalities in the area to offer services in their communities over the summer.
Are those the pools?
Yes, yeah.
Oh, good.
So we're currently with North Grenville, and we run the Kempville pool, so through them. And we also offer some day camps in Kempville as well, just across the park from the pool, which is really nice. So the kids have access to the pool.
Good.
And then in Prescott, we also operate the pool there.
Wow. I you're everywhere. You people are everywhere. You are indeed. So what I like about the Y and the swim, I'm going to call it the swim program, is that you can actually be certified too, and you go through the different levels, correct?
Yeah, yeah. So
oh,
it is
like
a progression
that.
Program
yeah.
where you earn badges and certificates
yes.
And progress to a next level, yes.
Yeah. Thank you. You put it much nicer than what I had, but you knew what I was talking about. That's the main thing. So, Emily, let's talk about the Ignite the Spark campaign for this year. It's the annual campaign. I know last year you did very well, right?
We did, yeah. So our goal last year, it was the Strong Communities campaign last year. And so our goal was a $420,000. And we actually, thanks to the generosity of the communities that we serve, raised $499,000. So we exceeded our target last year, which we're very proud of.
Oh, that is awesome. So this year, when does it actually start?
So it just launched this week.
Everything is this week. This is wonderful.
So yeah, it's a busy week. But yeah, so we've launched our Ignite the Spark campaign. And our goal for this year is there is an increase. And so we're hoping to raise $432,000 this year.
Good. And what does the funding that is raised, what does it go towards?
It goes to such a wide variety of programs and to people of all ages and stages. So we've served in 2023, over 30,000 meals to kids and teens who need food across the region. So that for us is a big one. That food security is really important, and we're able to provide that. We had over 4,000 visits to our teen drop-in on teen night, on Friday nights.
That is so popular, that teen night. Oh, yeah. I think it was really missed during the pandemic.
Yeah. And from that, our teen drop-in was born, where a lot of those meals are served weekly. Mm-hmm. And then we had over 500 fitness classes in those Mobile Y in those rural communities. So 500 classes that seniors got to participate in.
So any new programs at the Y that people should be aware of?
Yeah, we've got a couple new programs this spring, two specific ones at our Brockville location. We've got one for adults. It's a get ready for golf season kind of. So it's Golf Fit. So it's a fitness program, but designed to work those muscles and get you ready as golf season approaches, which is hopefully soon for the golfers out there. And then we've got another one for kids. And so this one is through the NHL, and it's called NHL Street. It's a ball hockey program.
Okay.
Where kids learn the sport of hockey. So kids who might not otherwise have the opportunity to play hockey or to learn a bit how to play and the rules.
Yes.
There's a wide variety of games that the staff use to teach them the skills and the rules of the game. And they actually get an NHL Street jersey that they get to take with them.
They do?
Yeah.
Now, this particular, or both of these programs, they're new. Do they only run, I would imagine the golf only runs for a certain amount of time. Correct.
Yeah. So the golf is a 4 or 5 week. It's about a 4 week program. It's a small group fitness class type program.
Right.
And then the NHL Street runs through our spring session.
Oh, good. Yeah. Okay. So there again, you know, go online and sign up.
Yeah.
And go for it. Anything else that you would like our viewers to know about the Y?
We've got a few. So part of our Ignite the Spark campaign, we do fundraising throughout the year. And we've got three events this year, or three big signature events in the community. And so the first one to kick off will be our Send a Kid to Camp. And so that helps us offset the cost of camp for families or provide the experience of summer camp for kids who might not otherwise benefit from that.
Right.
We're proud to say last year we offered over 350 weeks of camp to kids in the community.
That's
so
nice.
That's great.
Yes, it is.
And then we have our Gord Brown Memorial Golf Tournament, which we do in partnership with the United Way. So that'll be in August again this year. Date to be confirmed shortly.
Okay.
And then now we have our annual fire truck pull, which is in October annually. And
that has really grown, Emily. I'm not kidding. I mean, the teams that are now, you know, signing up for that.
It has, yeah. This is the 10th year of it.
The 10th year?
Yes.
I can't remember the first year.
I think we had two teams the first year.
Yes,
and I believe Ian McFall, who's one of our big supporters and organizers of that event, pulled on both, I think he said, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, it was a fun time. It was a fun time. Thank you ever so much for coming in, sitting down with me and telling me about the Y and all the great programs I have.
Thanks so much for having me today.
Hey, anytime.